Hello, we are Project Altair from Islamic University of Technology, Bangladesh. We present to you our Mars rover project, Musafir 2.0, which is still evolving and a result of over 1.5 years of development. Project Altair is a team of more than 80 undergraduate students working across various sub-teams, including mechanical, electrical, software, science, public relations, documentation, management and creative. The rover's electrical system is focused on dependency for maximum efficiency. The electrical box holds the fully functional and self-sufficient system that has been derived in two subsystems, power and control. The power setup features a central distribution board with multiple lithium batteries that supply energy to the entire system. It powers several key subsystems, including three microcontroller boards, each with its own custom-designed PCB. All of these microcontrollers are coordinated by a central mini-computer. The safety system of the rover consists of relays and a current sensor for automatic shutdown of the rover's electrical system in case of a short circuit or overcurrent. A red emergency stop button is located at the back of the rover. In case of an emergency, it can be pressed to shut down the rover's operation. The rover completely fits within a 1.2 meter cube square box. The rover and the base station setup can be done from fully off state to operational state within 10 minutes. The communication between Musafir and the base station is established using two communication systems, one for solely operating the rover manually and the other for getting rover visual and positional feedback and during autonomous operation. The communication systems are operated accordingly on 5.8 GHz and 2.4 GHz frequency bands. These systems enable the rover to be controlled and get feedback from a distance of up to 1.8 km. The rover is made of stainless steel and features a rocker bogie differential suspension system. It uses tire-based wheels interfacing with high-torque DC motors. The steering mechanism is set as skid steering. With Musafir's robust mechanical design, it can traverse challenging terrains, including soft sand, gravel, rough rocky surfaces, boulder fields, vertical drops, and steep, loosely consolidated slopes. Musafir 2.0 is equipped with a 5-degree of freedom stainless steel laser-cut body with aluminum wrist and a 3D-printed gripper. The arm is driven by actuators, with a worm gear for base rotation and a linear gripper. With the robust arm, Musafir can carry up to 5 kg object of mass seamlessly and can traverse with it. The rover is also equipped with a 3-degree of freedom extension that has a camera at its end. Upon reaching a designated location, the rover uses the extension to search and find objects, eliminating the need for a drone in delivery mission. The extension is also helpful at any task, providing rover surroundings and arm position feedback. With the zero backlash worm gear based rotation system, actuators, and lighter gripper, Musafir is able to perform the precision tasks at the equipment servicing task with ease. It can open a container, pick up test tube, place it in the container, place the container on a tight-fitted box and close it. With precise speed control, rover can manually flip switches, push buttons, open a hinged panel, operate joystick, turn knobs, insert Ethernet port, and plug in and out a USB. A linear actuator solenoid is placed at the static flow part of the gripper for typing on a keyboard. Currently, the typing is done manually. However, the autonomous model is being developed using visual feedback and open loop control, which is expected to be implemented before the on-site competition.
For the autonomous navigation mission, all the onboard sensors, cameras, microcontrollers integrate with the Jetson Xavier NX, and user interface GUI has been developed to assist with the autonomous control. Our current non-RTK GPS module has an accuracy of 1 meter, which is enough for the URC autonomous mission accuracy range. For the path planning, we are using GPS localization. Upon reaching the destination, the rover flashes green light and sends a signal to the base station. We are using OpenCV, Haruko library, and Python script to track and detect Haruko tags in the field outdoors. Our implementation is capable of detecting the tag's pose, distance from camera, and ID of the tag with accuracy and precision in any environment. Upon reaching the destination, the rover initiates a custom spiral search pattern to detect Haruko tags, and upon detecting it, stops within 2 meter vicinity of the post. Obstacles are detected using a real sense camera, and upon detection, a custom path is generated to avoid the obstacles and return to the original path. The real sense depth imaging along with localization will be used to generate dynamic cost map of the rover's environment. Our rover detects and localizes bottles, mallets using a custom trained single shot neural network.
The rover uses high resolution cameras for panoramic images and geological analysis and stores GNSS data for accurate site documentation.
For the subsurface sample, the rover scoop first clears the top centimeter of soil by moving it aside, then collects the sample from below this depth for analysis and stores it in a 3D printed PhD sample cache with a servo control lead that ensures a tight seal. The sample is dropped through a sieve to filter out larger particles before passing through a funnel into test tubes inside the science box for in-situ analysis. The science box features rotating test tubes, built-in cameras, and spectrophotometry. Visible spectrophotometry is used to analyze the results by measuring light absorption at specific wavelengths. Live detection tests include using the Bradford assay for proteins, Lugol's iodine test for Stark, and Sudan 3 test for lipids.
Using an actuator probe with integrated sensors, our rover collects real-time data on soil moisture and subsurface temperature by reaching a depth of 10 cm below the surface.
Our rover also measures atmospheric humidity, temperature, pressure, and wind speed.